good. So he knows how to turn. See if he'll go the other direction. Turn. Isn't he so smart? He's great. Good. So as Ernie's eating, I'm going to talk about his teeth for just a second. If you were to look at his teeth, you'll notice that he has four large teeth in the front, his incisors, and those things grow continuously. So he has to do things like branches and hard vegetation in order to wear them. It's really super scary, and it kind of is. So you can see that he has two layers of hair. This top layer is called the guard hairs, and if anything touches that, he'll assume that he is being attacked by a predator. And if that happens, he's going to poke out his back, and he's going to show these quills under here. And these quills are white with black spines on them. And those are very, very sharp, and again, they can detach from their body and get stuck into the skin. Now, something really cool about their quills is that they're covered in sort of an antiseptic sort of layer, so even if you do get poked by a porcupine's quill, you're not going to get an infection unless you really don't clean it out or anything like that. It's sort of an adaptation for porcupines being able to be around each other because they do run the risk of poking. You can see that there are some things falling off of him, and these are actually called quills. And quills are nothing different than specialized hairs. They have up to 30,000 quills covering their body, almost everywhere on their body, except for their underbelly. And those quills can be quite sharp. If you've ever had a